So we're here with strength and conditioning expert Brandon Krause. He's also a boxing trainer. Congratulations on your recent win with Jessie Martinez. Yeah. Jessie, come here really quick. 2-0. He's watching his own fight right now in the gym for the fifth time. It was a very entertaining fight. They threw nonstop punches, like keep punching. We're rock 'em sock 'em. Your face is clean, which is good. 2-0. How does it feel?
Feels good, man. Especially after a fight like that, when it was a really tough fight, very tough opponent, and it just feels good. And we got the victory.
Brandon, what did you tell him between rounds? Because he was just letting his hands go. The opponent was letting his hands go.
Trying to get Jessie to do a little bit more boxing and use some of those vast tricks that he has in his toolbox. But Jessie is very motivated to make fans and to give people their worth, and that's what he did. He went out there and just fought the toughest club fight you'll ever see against one of the toughest club fighters you're ever going to see.
In front of
Gustavo Lopez,
house.
If you're watching, we got respect for you, man. You're very tough. But guess what? Jesse's pretty tough, too.
Jessie, you ready to get back in there?
Yeah, hopefully for, I think, November, we're going to...
So you're going to fight once a month now, pretty much. That's the plan?
No, we would like to fight every other. We'd like to fight 5 or 6 times a year. You know, in everything, you know, it all depends on how the fights go, what the opportunities are. Building a career, it's tough. It's taking time, you know what I mean? Everybody wants to be the superstar quickly, but you got to pay your dues. You got to make your connections, and you got to win the fights, most importantly.
Is being a pro all what you thought it would be? Because you were an amateur, you made it to Team USA, you traveled to Haiti and other places. Now you're a pro.
Yeah, it's kind of like what I thought it would be. There's still a lot more to come, but for right now, yeah, it's very tough. You got to be really dedicated. You got to put in the work and you just got to fight hard.
Who's your favorite active fighter?
Active fighter, I have a couple. Probably Canelo, Rivendell.
People here might not know this, but you sparred Floyd Mayweather for his Andre Brito fight.
Yeah,
ever since that sparring, you've all attitude has changed. It elevated your game. Do you feel it?
Yeah, it gave me a lot of confidence, like being in there with Floyd, being able to like not only say like I could hang against Floyd, but I mean just to see how smart he is, how dedicated he is, and all of that gave me a lot of confidence.
Brandon, you've been following boxing for many, many years. This was your first time to be in a gym with Floyd as a fighter of yours sparring the champ, the TBE. What was it like? What do you take from that experience?
Just like what you guys were discussing, it was really a huge turning point confidence-wise for Jessie. And I've been telling the kid, you know, ever since he laced him up, that there's no one out there that he can't hang with, which means there's no one out there that he can't beat. And this just proved it. I mean, we're all in agreement that Floyd is pound for pound the best fighter right now. And Jessie was in there boxing with the guy, with the guy. They, longer than 6-minute rounds, you know.
With a hostile crowd of 200 people.
Yeah, they weren't our fans, that's for sure.
But Jessie, I did talk to him in Vegas, and I said, Floyd, Jessie Martinez and Juan Funes each told me that you have 14 hands. And he started giving you guys compliments. Like, they're young, they're up and coming, they gave me good work, you know, they'll have a good future. Did you watch the Mayweather Brito fight?
Yeah, I did.
What did you think?
Damn.
Brito said it was like sparring. Did you think it was sparring, or do you think just Mayweather just...
He's just too smart, man. Like, his boxing is, too good, footwork, everything, man. He just looked like on another level than Brito's.
What do you think, Brandon? Did you watch the fight?
I watched the fight, you know. I think what Berto said is true, and that's unfortunately why Berto had no chance. A minute and a half into the fight, you knew how it was going to go. Berto wasn't going to go beyond himself. He wasn't going to throw caution to the wind. He wasn't going to sell out at all during that fight. And he was content to not look too bad, make it 12 rounds with Floyd, and go home with $4 million.
What would you do? What would you do? I mean, he tried his hardest from the opening bell to the closing bell. He gave it his all.
Honestly, if we had that opportunity and we were in that time of our career where we're legitimately, challenging the pound-for-pound guy at welterweight for his title, we would come up with a plan to get a KO. You know, to go out there and give it our damnedest, you know?
49 have tried and 49 have failed. So how can you do something that no one's ever done? There's no blueprint.
No.
I walk with a limp because I have so much money in my pocket.
We would have to be the originators. We would have to come up with a unique it's hard, style though. To shock the world. Yeah, but what I'm saying is we would. We would go out there legitimately trying to win, and we would come up with a plan A, B, C, D, E, and F of things that we can do to disrupt, you know, the greatest boxer of the last 25 years. You know, you're not gonna outbox him. So you need to maybe set some traps. You maybe need to throw the correct combinations. You need to hustle a certain pace. You know, you're not gonna quote unquote get lucky with any punches, but you need to put yourself in the best possible position to land good shots.
I've heard that like 20 times already. But it's easier on the outside than once you're in the ring with Floyd, and Jesse was in the ring with him. You can't touch him. He stands in front of you, yeah, and you can't.
But I guess
tell Brandon about that because he doesn't. He thinks
I guess
like
something like what Maidana did though. Like Maidana.
But Maidana's so awkward. You can't train for him because his punches come from his back.
Yeah, that's
they don't come
and
like.
He's such a powerful guy as well.
Yeah, and Floyd took his best shot.
Yeah, he was really aggressive against him too. He did really good like for the first half of the fight and then kind of faded out.
Okay, so when you get to become a grandpa, what do you tell your grandkids about sparring Floyd? How would you describe it?
I'll just be me letting them know I sparred against the best of this generation, maybe the best ever.
I mean, the story of his career is just only starting to be written. So when we're a few chapters deep, you know, maybe we're talking about how the current pound for pound guy sparred with the old pound for pound guy many years back.
There you have it. Last thing, if Mayweather spars you again, what would you try to do different? Or just nothing, you just do your best?
Just do the best I can, yeah. Get the most experience I can out of it.
So, Jose, if you had to come up with a nickname for Floyd based on the sparring, what would you call him?
I don't know. I wouldn't know, man. Just too smart.
Too smart.
Too smart.
There you have it. FaceNewsReporting.com. I'm Malisa Quack reporting.